Hello everyone, Savartech here once again, and in this video I'm going to show you how to create a live boot Linux such that you have enough space to update it and add more things in there. Most of the time when you create a live boot machine, it only gives you about 3 or 4 gigabytes, but in this video I'll show you how to get more. So first of all, you'll need to get Rufus. The link is on the description how to get that. It's not really rocket science. And Linux Mint is what we're going to be using today, but you could do that with Kali, Parrot OS, or whatever, for that matter. Let's get started here by opening Rufus. Once you open it, you're going to select the USB thumb drive that you're going to be using for that. And then you're going to select ISO image here, and select the actual disk image that you're going to be using for the installation. This one is what I'm going to be using, and I'll click open here. The important part here, I know you've done all this before, but this is what you need to do. You need to drag this persistent partition size up to whatever you need it. I don't have this is like only 16 gigs, so it's going to give 4 gigs to the Linux things and stuff, and I'll give 10 to the storage. I could have give it like 12, but I need to leave a little bit of slack, so I'll give it like 10 or 11, and I'll leave those as is. And basically what that is storage space, and when you try to update it, it won't give you an error like no space left on disk, and you can store a lot of things. Another upside to that is you can actually shut down that live boot machine, and when you turn it back on, everything you did is still there. Your images you downloaded and all that thing is still there. I guess that could be a disadvantage for some people as well, but all you would have to do really is come back here and reformat it, right? So I guess there is more pluses than minuses. So just hit start here, and I'll go ahead and say yes. Pretty much once you hit start, I'd say you just let it run and it should be good. Once this progress bar is filled up, you're gonna go close it as usual, and we're gonna test it real quick for you to see what I mean. To confirm the changes that were made, I booted from that actual thumb drive, and as you can see, this is the report for it. You can access that by doing df space dash h, and you can see that information. And right there where I highlighted is the partition, the part of the USB where things are stored. And you can see the available memory, the available storage space, the use percentage, and all that stuff. So thank you for watching this video. Don't forget to subscribe and like, and I'll see you on the next one.